Hi guys, and welcome to another Elementor video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we had a question on one of my other Elementor videos, and somebody wanted to know how to have some text, and when they hovered over it, they wanted to change into an image, fade into an image like this. I've got a whole series on Elementor hover effects, and I'll put the playlist link below the video. But June, it was that asked the question. Really simple. Here's a really simple way of doing it. So I've got this page open already with my Elementor here, and I've got three columns. I've got a section with three columns in it. Let's just add a text module to our third column there. Text editor module, simply left click, pull it over and release. And there it is. I'll do the same as I did here. Let's just drop that down. And we'll make the first two into a title. There we go, fantastic. Now we want to hover over this and have it disappear and have an image appear. Now the way this works, and a lot of these hover effects do, the image itself is going to reside in the column, the little dark tab there, the column that the text module is actually sitting on. There's a little gap, top, bottom, right and left on our column between the column and the text module. We'll get rid of that and we'll put an image in. So let's now go into the column and we'll choose an image. Probably land here when you go in the column. If you want to go over to style, you'll find background. Just open it up, hit the little paintbrush there, and it'll give you a place to add an image. Doesn't matter for our example here. Let's grab that one. Okay, it's put the image in there. If your image looks like this, you can change the size of it down here. I'm going to have mine cover, or you can contain, which will just show the shape of the image and it'll do a duplicate underneath. Cover works perfectly for me though, so I'll leave mine on cover. And if we hover over, like I said, there's a bit of space in our text module, in our column, between the column and the text module there. Let's get rid of that. To do that, we need to go to the Advanced tab, go down to Padding right here, just put a zero in that first column. As long as this little change checked, it'll do all four at once for you. Now we've got no space there. That's just exactly what we wanted. But of course, we don't want to see that image until we hover over it. So we need to cover it up with the same color background as our page here. So let's go back into the text module. And we'll go to advanced. Down here you'll find background. Hit the little paintbrush. Let's add a color. I know my background's white here. So I'm going to make it white by dragging it top left corner there. FFFFF is white. And as you can see, that's giving it a white background and it's covering up some of our image here. But we want to cover up the top bit and the bottom bit, so let's give it a little bit of padding to try and do that. Still in our advanced tab, we'll go up to advanced padding. I'm going to uncheck this because I just want to do the top and bottom. Let's try giving it 50 on the top and 50 on the bottom. There we go, that's covered it up nicely. And also I think I want to put my text in the middle, so we'll go to style and center align the text. Fantastic. So we can't see our image and we can see our text. Now we've got to use a bit of custom CSS to make this disappear. And still in the text module, I'm going to go to the advanced, and you're going to find CSS ID and CSS classes. You can do it with either or. We're going to use a class today and I'll call it hovbox. You can call it whatever you want to call it, as long as it makes sense to you, and it's got to be unique, obviously. Because if you create any other boxes and give them this class, they will do whatever we tell them to do with the CSS in a moment. Okay, so we've given this a CSS class. We want to make sure this is updated. If you're using the pro version, you can put custom CSS in here. I'm going to presume you're using the free version. I'll show you how to do it with that. What I'm going to do now is make sure this page is all published. I'm going to go over to my theme customizer. So if you go down to dashboard, appearance and customize, it'll bring you to this page right here. Now I've already got mine set as the home page right here. So what I suggest you do is temporarily make this page your home page so you can work with it with CSS. You can always change it back afterwards when you're done. So you can see it right here. You don't actually need to do this, but it's just visually helps you out a little bit. Now let's go to our additional CSS, and this is where we're going to write our CSS. So we gave it a class of hovbox. All classes have to have a period or a dot in front of them. So it's a dot, then the class name, hovbox. Now we want to set a hover state for it. So after the X of hovbox, I'm going to put a colon, and with no space, the word hover. So that's no space between the X and the colon, and no space between the colon and the hover. I'm going to put a space and open and close some curly brackets. Inside the curly brackets is where we'll write our CSS. Now basically, that's saying hovbox, this thing, hover, when we put our mouse on it, what do we want it to do? We want it to disappear. So I'm going to make it transparent by saying opacity 0. And opacity 0 is completely transparent, and opacity 1 is fully visible, and you can do increments of 0.1, 0.2, etc., and it increment up in see-throughness, if you will. Okay, there we are, and it's working already. When we hover over, that image is jumping in there. Just what we wanted. But that's kind of instant. I like it to be a little more graceful, like this one here. That's entirely up to you, though. And if you want to do that, we'll just write another bit of CSS. And don't bother copying this as I'm doing it in real time. I'll write it for you and put it down below the video. You can copy it and change it however you wish. So to make this a bit slower, let's give it our class name again. Class name, period, hovbox, space, open and close some curly brackets. And this is just a regular state now. When our mouse is not on it, what do we want it to do? So I want to say transition dash duration colon, and we'll give it a time in seconds. You can give it 0.5 seconds, 0.2 seconds, 1.5 seconds. I'm going to make mine fairly slow, so I'm going to say 1.2 seconds, and that should slow it down and be a bit more graceful. There we go. See, the image is in, it sort of fades out gradually, and the text fades in gradually. I like that. So we need to hit publish now to make these permanent. And let's go back to our page and refresh. Just make sure it's going to work on the front end here. I'm sure it will. There we go. There we go. There's our image. When we let go of it, there's our text. When we hover over our text, changes the image. Really simple hover effect, but it's very effective. Now, if you wanted to change it around, if you wanted to have the image first, and then when you hover over it, the text to appear, just flip around your CSS over here. So let's go back in here, and we'll flip it around. On the hover state, we'll say opacity 1, and we're going to say opacity 0 in the regular state, and it should disappear as soon as I put this 0 in. There we go. So now we've got an image. When we hover over it, the text is going to appear. So it's the opposite of this one here. Really easy to do. Like I say, I'll put this down below the video. You're welcome to use it how you will. Hit the publish to make it permanent. Let's go and refresh our page here. That image should appear when we refresh the page. There it is. Now when we hover over it, we've got the text. So there you go, there's image to text, and there's text to image. Really easy to do. So I hope that answered your question, and like I say, I've got a whole series on Elementor hover effects. I'll put the playlist below the video. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.